Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. Today I want to share a clip from my weekly office hours session that I host in the Creative X crew, which is my free community for professional designers and developers, freelancers and founders. During these sessions, I answer questions, provide design feedback, live coaching calls, and I also host lectures and workshops, all with the sole purpose of helping you succeed as a designer. If that sounds like you, join the crew. The link is down below in the description and the pinned comment. Without further ado, cue the clip.
Okay, do you see my screen?
Yes.
So that's the first version. That's the one that I have actually.
Okay.
So I'm just going to show it to you. Here we show some stats about web design, why it's important. And there we are talking about our services. And then the work that we have. Also some reviews. So that's
nice.
It
from our customers.
A little phrase, a quote. And now a little bit about us with a link to the About Us page. And finally, our blog and a call to action. So that's the home page, and we have all the other pages. Actually, we are redesigning the home page. I can show you. But what's your thoughts about this one?
Yeah, I love the color scheme. Like, it's striking, strong. Your choice in typography overall, you got nice hierarchy between headings, body copy, calls to action, like nice differentiation. Your elements too, like you create pattern disrupts where it's not all the same through the scroll. Like you've got, like you've spanned the full width here. You've got this parallax image in the background with text in front. You've got another layout style for your testimonials. You know, you've got your blog articles in like that mosaic style kind of layout offset component. Like you're utilizing different layout styles to create interest. So as we scroll, there's even background video. As we scroll, we don't lose our attention. Like it's new. Every time we scroll down, there's something new to take in. Large expressive typography for your headings. Yeah, I think very well done. I like the color scheme. It really shows that you have an understanding in what in your craft. So as someone who's trying to buy it, like if I'm looking at this and I'm your target market and I see you're selling design and your ability to design, I could see, oh, you know how to do this. Like it's, you're not trying to sell a design service and you're not a good designer, you know?
So I'm going to show you the new one that we are building right now.
Okay.
It's kind of the same, but with a little bit of tweaks and animations. So let's go. Okay. So first we have this section that go over like that. And now we showed directly the work in this case, in this panel. Scrolling like that.
That's cool.
We have some logos of of our past clients.
Yeah.
And now we have our services, web design, branding, and now the reviews. So it's gonna be a slider. I didn't finish it, but yeah, it's gonna be a slider.
Oh, cool.
Slider.
Yeah.
And now we have a code and the section about us, and finally the blog. And the call to action with this little effect. So that's the new version.
Nice. Yeah. I like that. I like that you just took what was good about the existing version and refined it, added to it. You didn't fully transform it because I don't think it was necessary to. It's like you made a variation on it that added a little bit more visual interest and interaction. Just, you know, and so it's very, very well done. I like that. And I like the takeover. When you hover over a portfolio item, a page takeover, but then it goes away. Very cool.
Thanks. I wasn't sure about the section, so it's reassuring me.
Yeah, I think it's a neat take on it. You know, like it's, I think it's an interesting artistic approach to like how it just kind of goes over top of that section intentionally.
But does it show well the work? Does it bring it in value? I don't know how to say it in English. Does it show the work well?
Does it highlight your work well?
Exactly.
Yes. So here's the thing is it's showing your work. But the other thing is like, you got to remember that your best portfolio piece is the portfolio itself, is the website itself. Okay. So like, yes, these are nice and you're highlighting it well, you're giving it a moment and then you know, you could click through to a case study or something, but your own website is the best portfolio piece, you know, so that they can see, wow, this is good. Like I can see that you've got chops and then you're showing we can apply this to other businesses or people as well.
I can show you the project page.
Yeah.
I'll show it to you.
Our projects.
If you have any like critique improvement I can put in, you just tell me.
Yeah, for sure. So this open a case study page?
Exactly. Okay. Exactly. That's the feed. We have the little mosaic and the overanimation.
Okay.
So, tuck. We have a little bit of information about the project. So that's the information about the company. Yeah. We have the button for the website. Now we have what we did actually for the work. The brief. A little image right there. And the result, a little information about that. Mm-hmm. A video that show the website in action.
Smart.
And a screenshot of the full homepage.
Like nice. Very cool.
Bit of tech, tech, tech. Also, we have the review right there.
Yep.
And we have the link to the next project. And the call to action.
Beauty. C'est très bien.
Good French.
Yeah, merci. Is this all in Editor X?
Yeah, of course.
Amazing. Wow. I'm impressed. I think it was smart that you showed a screenshot and a video of the website because if you link off to the site, which is fine, it creates opportunity that if that client hires another designer or they get their hands on it and they break it or they mess it up or it's no longer in line with the vision that you created and implemented, then it looks bad on you. Whereas if you show like, this was the work I created, whatever they did with it afterwards, it's not me, but this is what I created. And so you've shown that without sending them away to somebody else's irrelevant site, you know, but you can see like, yes. Like I can see what you did here, it makes sense. And you explain it in your case study. Yeah, very cool.
Thanks a lot. So I'm gonna show you the last page because I have the occasion. I'm gonna take it.
yeah, absolutely.
I'm gonna show you like the page about us. Excuse me, I think that's it. So there's a little information about us. Right there, there's our mission with a little over animation.
Yeah. Ooh, nice.
Now there's the team, so me and my co-founder.
Yeah.
With little information about us and why choose us, a section telling why to choose us.
Yeah.
And another CTA.
Brilliant. Honestly, like, I wish I could give you some, like, some hard feedback on what should change.
That's what I need.
and I get it. Like, I don't want to be the guy who's just like, yay, this is so great. It's so good. Everything's good. Never change. It's like, no. I think it's good to push yourself. And so, but I got to tell you that the fact that I'm kind of unable to instantly tell you this has to change here or this is, that shows that the issues that you might have are more nuanced and subtle. Which means like you've already smashed all the big components, all the big roadblocks that you typically would see in a web design and in the way that you're outlining your services. Like you've done a lot of work. Even your headshots are professional. Like they're good. It's just like, so I'm very impressed. It very clearly illustrates a high-end professional agency website. Like it's something that you would see. So like, well done. This is very well done.
Thanks a lot. That means a lot for real.
Of course. No, it's like, it's my pleasure. It's so great. What I'll do is like, I'll pull up your site afterwards here and I'll see if I can find something that you should fix. Like, I'd love to give you some like, aha, I found something.
I'm going to show the link, give the link in the chat.
Yeah, please do. The link in the chat there. Yeah, I'd love to be able to give you some feedback, even if it's more subtle, even if it's like, your line height, you know what? Let's start like tweaking subtle things here. Cause then if you're already a 9 out of 10, let's make it a 10 out of 10. Cause that, you know, there's always room to grow.
That's true. Well, thanks a lot. That's been a lot.
Perfect. Yeah. My pleasure. Thanks for coming on. Thanks so much for watching that. If you liked it, tap the like button and consider subscribing to the channel so you don't miss any of our videos. And if you loved it and want some more, join us in the CreativeX crew. While you're here, why not check that video out? Cheers.